Well, hey there, my fabulous friends, and happy Mother's Day. Man, do you like how I kind of dressed up a little bit for Mother's Day? Am I looking good or what? Hey, I know you guys are looking good. Man, I love you, and I'm so glad you're back for another week of an awesome lesson about Jesus and God and what he's doing for us. Man, it is so awesome to be here. And don't forget, like I already said, it is Mother's Day, and I'm pretty sure you already remember that. But let's go give Mom that big hug, that big kiss, and just tell her how much you love her. So let's also get up, and hey, if your mom's in the room, get her to sing with you. Let's sing these two songs to the Lord. Let's sing out loud. Let's let him know we're here. And then I got a special surprise in Mr. Greg's backyard. I'll be right back.
Yeah.
Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Mr. Craig's Backyard. I'm glad you could join me. So, about this time last year, if you remember, for some of you who are watching, and we were checking on a bird house that I had. And we went and we checked on it, and it had eggs, but they were already hatched and they were all gone. The birds were gone, and there was one little egg that never did hatch. Remember, we saw it, we dug down in there. Anyway, check that video about last year sometime. It's still posted. So this year we're back, and it is a couple of weeks sooner, so we're gonna see what we can find in this bluebird house. So I have seen bluebirds around going out and in and about, so let's see if they built a nest. And careful, and see if there's anything in it. So I be careful and not disturb it too much, just in case. And then flew out. Open it up just a little bit, and let's see. Oh yes, there is little baby birds in there. Can you see them? It's hard to see. Look at there. Oh, did you see them move? Yeah. Mama's gonna have to. Mama's probably out looking for some food. Oh, they're sleeping good. All right, let's close it back up. Get out of here, cause I don't want Mama. Mom bird or daddy bird to come after me. All right, got it locked up. All right, hey, how cool was that? We saw them. We'll check back on them and see how they're growing and see if they're awake maybe in a couple of weeks, and we'll see what's going on. Well, that's it for now in Mr. Greg's Backyard. I will see you later. Wow, was that neat? Man, I'm glad we got to see those little baby birds. Wow, they were just born. They're so tiny. And hey, their mom bird, their mother bird, she's celebrating Mother's Day too, but she's out there looking for food for them. Man, that's awesome. I can't wait till we go back and check them out later. But hey, you know, it's really neat that everything that we've been talking about is Jesus, and where he's been walking here on earth and doing all these miracles and stuff. And then we saw him go back up to heaven, and now he sent us the Holy Spirit that we've been talking about. But you know, it's always neat to go back and just remember the very beginning. So we're gonna roll back into time for Jesus and celebrate this Mother's Day about the baby Jesus. Check this out.
John, one of Jesus' disciples, wrote to tell people about who Jesus is. John wrote that the word Jesus existed in the beginning, before the world even began. The Word has always existed with God, and the Word has always existed as God. He was with God in the beginning. When God spoke at creation, all things were created through His Word. Not one thing was created apart from Him. The Word brought life into the world and light for all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness could not hide it. God sent a man named John the Baptist to be a witness to the light. John was not the light, but he came to tell people about the light so they might believe. The true light was coming into the world to give light to everyone. When Jesus came into the world, people did not recognize him. His own people did not accept him, but this is good news. To everyone who did accept him, he gave them the right to be a part of God's family, to be children of God. The Word became a human and lived among us. People saw his glory, the glory of the one and only Son of God. He was full of grace and truth. John the Baptist told people that even though Jesus came into the world after him, Jesus is greater because he existed before John. People received blessings from Jesus, grace upon grace. Long ago, God gave people the law through Moses. But now, he has given us grace and truth through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God, but Jesus, God's one and only Son, has shown us what God is like. The birth of Jesus was good news. Jesus was no ordinary baby. He was God's Son, sent to earth from heaven. Jesus came into the world as a human to bring us life. He brought light into darkness and showed us what God is like.
Oh, wow, was that a cool story or what? Man, they talked a lot about John the Baptist because he was just talking about the baby Jesus. And what a great thing to be talking about on Mother's Day is, hey, you know, you were a little bitty baby once upon a time too. So, hey, let's get back out there, celebrate with our moms all day. Just tell her how much we love her. And hey, I love you so much that you would join me today too. All right, let's celebrate the Lord all week long, and I will see you next week. Love you.
Hi there, I'm Pastor Brian, and it's time for Questions from Kids. Kayla from Lake Bluff, Illinois asks,
was Jesus born on December 25th?
That is a great question, Kayla. Was Jesus born on December 25th? You know, in today's session, of course, we're celebrating the birth of Jesus, that he came to earth, became a person so that he could bring us life. And we traditionally celebrate this on December 25th, of course, but we aren't sure of the exact day when Jesus was born. We just don't have those records. So it may have been December 25th, or it may have been a different date. Some people believe he may have actually been born in the spring. But here's what is really important for us to understand. It's interesting to think about when Jesus was actually born, but that's not what we're celebrating, is it? We're celebrating why that he was born. And we can celebrate this, and we should celebrate this at all times. Think about it. Whether he was born on December 25th or April 6th, it really doesn't matter, because the same truth is what we celebrate, that the Son of God came to earth, became a person, was born, and then he lived, he died, and he raised again from the dead. Why? So that he could provide us with forgiveness of sin and bring us into relationship with God. That truth is too big, it's too beautiful to confine to one day, whether that's December 25th or again some other day. We want to celebrate that every day of the year, every minute of every day of the year, because it is so beautiful and so important. So I hope that helps you give some understanding about not really focused on December 25th, but the birth and the meaning of Jesus coming to earth. So here's a question back for you. What does your family do to celebrate Jesus' birth?